Hello and how are you? Hey friends, welcome to the Shen Show. I am your host, Shen It All Fresco, coming to you from right here in where else but St. Charles, Missouri. Hey, you know what? Today is Thursday, August the 19th, 2021. Got a happy birthday shout out going out to Jocelyn Perkins and Daniel Remiger. So without further ado, here's a birthday song for the two of you. I said, hey, Jocelyn, hey, Daniel, hey, yard, it's your birthday today. So happy birthday, I must say. You know, that's a one more year gone away. So happy birthday to you, I say. I said, hey, David, hey, Daniel, hey, Jocelyn, hey, yard, it's your birthday today. Why, that's another trip around the sun that you made. I hope you're enjoying your special day, because I'm having your happy birthday day today. Oh, why, yes, it's your happy birthday day today. Alright, hey, there's your happy birthday shout-outs going out to Jocelyn and Daniel. Hopefully you guys will be having many more. Cha-cha-cha-cha-cha-cha. Alrighty then. Got some Shen Show likes. That would be Lot Abaya and my Pokey pal, Amanda S. Little. Those are the Shen Show shout outs for today. And let's see. It looks like weather forecast coming up for the next 5 days. Next 5 day forecast, weather forecast, going to be brought to you today by Refreshing Word Fellowship Church. Refreshing Word Fellowship Church is located at 2054 Campus Drive, St. Charles, Missouri, 63301. It is pastored by ordained pastor John Schumer. Christian Fellowship Church is a what do they call that? They call it a non-denominational church. That's what it is. Sure enough. Anyway, we have our services are on Sundays at 11 a.m. in the morning, and then we have an hour of power prayer on Thursdays at 1:30 to 2:30, or sometimes it stretches for a few hours or more, or an hour or so more, because, well, hey, that hour may not be enough. Once the Spirit gets in, it's you never know how long He's going to stay, so we just might stay all day. Anyway, that's on Thursdays, 1:30 to 2:30 p.m. at Refreshing Word Fellowship Church, located across from Greener's Pub in off of Campus Drive. That's right behind Save a Lot, St. Andrew's Plaza, across the street from St. Andrew's Annex. Big brown cross right there. All are welcome to learn the word, so that you know, you will know, where and which path you need to straighten out on, so that you can become one of God's chosen. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Alright, here we go. Weather forecast for the St. Charles viewing area. Well, it's a good nice 85 degrees out there right now. But that temperature is going to be slowly dropping because it's mostly clear skies overnight tonight with low temperatures around 72 degrees Fahrenheit. Winds are going to be light and variable southeast at about 6 miles per hour. And then for Friday, August the 20th, sunshine and clouds mixed together. A stray shower or thunderstorm is quite possible. High temperatures of 89 degrees Fahrenheit with winds southeast at 5 to 10 miles per hour. But partial cloudiness early with scattered showers and thunderstorms later during the night. Storms may contain strong gusty winds. Low temperatures around 74 degrees Fahrenheit with winds south at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Chances of rain 60%. And then for Saturday, August the 21st, partly to mostly cloudy skies. Highs with skies with scattered thunderstorms in the morning. Storms may contain strong gusty winds. High temperatures of 89 degrees Fahrenheit with winds west to southwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Chances of rain 40%. Mostly clear skies during the evening with low temperatures of 68 degrees Fahrenheit and winds north to northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. And then we have a Sunday, August the 22nd. Partly cloudy skies with highs near 90 degrees Fahrenheit. Winds light and variable northeast at about 5 miles per hour. And then mostly clear skies overnight with low temperatures around 73 degrees Fahrenheit and winds southeast at about 5 miles per hour. Monday, August the 23rd, mostly sunny skies with high temperatures around 97 degrees Fahrenheit. Winds are going to be southwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour with partly cloudy skies and low temperatures near 75 degrees Fahrenheit. Winds will be light and variable, which is south to southwest at about 6 miles per hour. And then for our fifth and final day forecast day, Tuesday, August the 24th, a few clouds from time to time with high temperatures of 97 degrees Fahrenheit. Winds will be south to southwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. A few clouds from time to time with low temperatures around 75 degrees Fahrenheit. Winds will be south at 5 to 10 miles per hour. And that is your 5-day forecast for the St. Charles viewing area. Brought to you by Jamie's Wreaths. That's right, seasonal wreaths by Jamie. Yep, quite the crafty gal, Jamie O'Driscoll. Just jump on her webpage or her Facebook page and check out her products. Boy, I tell you what, she can decorate up anything. So give it a shot. Check it out, seasonal wreaths by Jamie. All right, let's see what's going on in town. What's going on in St. Charles? Freebie. What be freebie? What be freebie? Festival of the Little Hills, that what be freebie. That's coming on up, that's for sure, for sure. Don't forget to get down there to the Festival of the Little Hills, August 25th through the 22nd. Reoccurring daily, 4:30 p.m. to 10 o'clock p.m. on Friday the 20th, 9:30 a.m. to 10 p.m. on Saturday the 21st, and 9:30 a.m. to 5 o'clock p.m. on Sunday the 22nd. Located where? Main Street, St. Charles. That's right, 230 South Main Street, all the way up and down Main. St. Charles, Missouri. Alrighty, that would be in the old Main Street Mall area, basically, from the Capitol down south. Down South Main, North Main, that's down north, but that's all right, up north, and there'll be crafts and largest festival of the year. Activities include over 300 craft booths with some demonstrations by the crafters and people, and the artisans doing their thing. Also include numerous food and beverage booths, along with live music and other entertainment. Kids' corners are available for entertainment, shuttles, and more. Click the website above, which would be... it just says website. It doesn't say what the website's called. It says about blank. No, it says festivalofthelittlehills.com. Don't forget to go to the festival at littlehills.com just to see what's going to go on and to enjoy yourself. Come on down. Festival dates and times are available, and over there on that website, festivalofthelittlehills.com, you will find what bands are playing, what bands are taking the bandstands, and everything that's going on. So head on over there. Alrighty then, let's see, that weather forecast is done. We're going to do some singing. This was a song I was turned on to today while I was at church at the hour of power prayer. But it goes something like this. Who am I that the Lord of all the earth would care to know my name, would care to feel my hurt? Who am I that the bright and morning star would choose to light the way for me, my ever-wandering heart. Not because of who I am, but because of what you've done. Not because of what I've done, but because of who you are. I am a flower quickly fading, here today and gone tomorrow. A wave tossed in the ocean, oh ocean. A vapor in the wind, still you hear me when I'm calling. Lord, you catch me when I'm falling, and you've told me who I am. I am yours, I am yours. Who am I that the eyes that see my sin would look on me with love and watch me arise again? Who am I that the voices that climbed the sea, oh, would call out through the rain and claim the storm in me? Not because of who I am, but because of what you have done. Not because of what I've done, but because of who you are. I am a flower quickly fading, here today and gone tomorrow. A wave tossed in the ocean, a vapor in the wind, still you hear me when I'm calling. Lord, you catch me when I'm falling, and you have told me who I am. I am yours, not because of who I am, not because of, but because of what you've done. Not because of what I've done, but because of who you are. This is not the version I was thinking of. We're going to try it again by going like this. Who am I? Elvis Presley song lyrics.
When I think of how he comes so far from glory, come to dwell among the lonely such as I, to shuffle shame and such grace, one moment, Calvary, you take my place. Then I ask myself this question, who am I? Who am I that the king would plead and die for? Who am I that he would pray, not my will, thy Lord? The answer, I may never know why he ever loved me so. That to an old rugged cross he'd go, for who am I? When I'm reminded of his words, I leave you never. If you'll be there true, I'll give you your life forever. Oh, I wonder what I could have done to deserve God's only Son, to fight my battles until they're won. For who am I? Who am I that the king would bleed and die for? Who am I that he would pray, not my will, but thy Lord? The answer, I may never know why he ever loved me so. That to an old rugged cross he'd go. for who am I? That an old rugged cross he'd go for, who am I?
All right, that was the Elvis tune. All right, hey, it looks like it's time for the Grandpa, TV Grandpa, story time with TV Grandpa. That's right. Story time with TV Grandpa Shen. And we're going to bring all the kids in, right? Let's bring all the kids in for story time. And here we go. We're going to do Jack and the Beanstalk today. Well, once upon a time, there lived a poor widow and her son Jack. One day, Jack's mother told him to take their only cow. And then Jack went to the market, and on his way, he met a man who wanted to buy his cow. Jack asked, "What will you give me in return for my cow?" The man answered, "I will give you 5 magic beans." Jack took the magic beans and gave the man the cow. But when he reached home, Jack's mother was very angry. She said, "You fool! He took away your cow and gave you some beans." She threw the beans out the window. Jack was very sad and went to sleep without dinner. The next day, when Jack woke up in the morning and looked out the window, he saw that the beans had grown a very huge beanstalk, and it reached a kingdom in the sky, and there lived a giant and his wife. Well, Jack went inside the house and found, he saw a huge beanstalk had grown from his magic beans. He climbed up the beanstalk and reached a kingdom in the sky. There he lived a giant and his wife. Jack went inside the house and found the giant's wife in the kitchen. And Jack said, "Could you please give me something to eat? I am so hungry." Well, the kind wife gave him some bread and some milk. And while he was eating, the giant came home. And the giant was very big and looked very fearsome. Jack was terrified and went and hid inside, while the giant cried out,
3, 5, 0, 5, I smell the blood of an Englishman. Be he alive or be he dead, I'll grind his bones to make my bread.
Well, the wife said, "There is no boy in here." So the giant ate his food and then went to his room. He took out his sacks of gold coins, counted them, and kept them aside. Then he went to sleep. Well, in the night, Jack crept out of his hiding place, took one sack of gold coins, and climbed down the beanstalk. And at home, he gave the coins to his mother, who was very happy, and they lived well for quite some time. Well, after a while, they had spent out all the gold coins. So Jack climbed up the beanstalk and went to the giant's house again. Once again, Jack asked the giant's wife for some food. But while he was eating, the giant returned. And Jack leapt up in a fright and went and hid under the bed. Well, the giant cried out,
3, 5, 0, 5. I smell the blood of an Englishman. Be he alive or be he dead, I'll grind his bones to make my bread.
Well, the wife said, "There is no boy in here." And the giant ate his food and went to his room. There he took out a hen, and he shouted, "Lay." And then the hen laid a golden egg. It was a goose. The goose laid the golden egg, and when the giant fell asleep, Jack took the goose, and he climbed down the beanstalk. And Jack's mother was very happy with him. And after some days, Jack once again climbed the beanstalk and went to the giant's castle for the third time. Jack met the giant's wife and asked for some food. Once again, the giant's wife gave him bread and milk, but while Jack was eating, the giant came home.
Fee, fi, fo, fum, I smell the blood of an Irishman. Be he alive or be he dead, I'll grind his bones to make my bread, cried the giant.
Don't be silly. There is no boy in here, said the wife. And the giant had a magical harp that could play beautiful songs. While the giant slept, Jack took the harp and was about to leave, and suddenly the magic harp screamed out. Cried out for help, master, a boy is stealing me. And the giant woke up and he saw Jack with the harp. Furious, he ran after Jack, but Jack was too fast for him, and he ran down the beanstalk and reached the home. The giant followed him down, but Jack quickly ran inside the house and fetched an axe, and he began to chop down the beanstalk. Well, when he did, the giant fell from the beanstalk. As it fell and crashed to the ground, the giant was killed, and Jack and his mother were now very rich, and they lived happily ever after. And that was Jack and the Beanstalk, and that is the end of the TB Grandpa Show. Okay? Alrighty. Hey, kids can stick around for a little bit of the Bible if you'd like to, because it tends to be the Daily Bread portion of the program. And the Daily Bread portion of the program is brought to you today by
The Bible with Briscoe 2021. The Bible with Briscoe 2021 is a daily reading of the Bible to be completed within 1 year. Today's daily reading of the Bible with Briscoe 2021 is Psalms 103 through 104 and 1 Corinthians 2. Don't forget to tune into the Bible with Briscoe 2021 for your daily reading of the Bible.
Okay, hey, that's it for it's time for the Daily Bread portion of the program, which the devotion is Remember and Celebrate. And today's scriptures to go along with Remember and Celebrate is Luke 22:14 through 23. When the hour came, Jesus and his apostles reclined at the table, and he said to them, I have eagerly desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer, for I tell you, I will not eat it again until it finds fulfillment in the kingdom of God. And after taking the cup, he gave thanks, and he said, take this and divide it among you, for I tell you, I will not drink again from the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God comes. And he took a bread, and he gave thanks and broke it, and he gave it to them, saying, this is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. And in the same way, after the supper, he took the cup, saying, this is the new covenant, and in my blood, which is poured out for you. But the hand of him who is going to betray me is within mine on the table. And the Son of Man will go as it has been decreed, but woe to the man who betrays him. And they began to question among themselves which of them it might be who would do this. That was Luke 22:14 through 23, which concludes the Daily Bread portion of the program for today, which was brought to you today by
The Bible with Briscoe 2021,
a daily reading of the Bible to be completed within 1 year. Do not forget to tune into your Bible with Briscoe 2021 to get your daily reading of the Bible. All right, my friends, hey, that looks like it. That's the nutshell of the Shin Show wrapped up. And time for me to go. I got one more song for you, though, and it goes,
well, goodbye, my friends. It's time to go. bother, goodbye, my friends, it's time to go. I hate to leave you, but I really must go. So goodbye, my friends, goodbye. Goodbye, my friends, goodbye. This here has been Shenandoah Briscoe saying hello, and how are you? Thanks for tuning in to the Shen Show, and as always, you know, God loves you, and so do I. So come back and see me tomorrow, because, well, hey, I'll be here, and I hope that you are too.